Hey everybody, this is Jeff with BigSquidRC.com and we're on day 5 of our Evader DT week. Today I'm going to be starting to detail the new body. We're going to be doing this in two parts. Today I'll be working on the hard plastic parts. I'm going to clean them up, sand them down a little bit, reuse them on the new body. I'm going to give them a paint job to add a little bit of extra detail to this truck. Let's take a look at some of the tools you'll need to complete this little project today. You'll need a Phillips head screwdriver to remove some of the smaller parts off the body, like the side mirrors and the toolbox. You'll need a pair of needle nose pliers to remove some of the clips that are holding on the larger pieces of the body, the roll bar and the rear bumper and whatnot. If you're going to detail the tires, it's a little easier to do it when they're off the truck, so you'll need a 7mm nut driver. You'll also need a selection of paints. I'm using just off-the-shelf enamel spray paints from my local hardware store. I have some primer here, gloss black, and a silverish chrome kind of color. I've never used this before, so it's going to be a bit of an experiment for me. But I think the way I'm going to do it is put the primer down on everything, then put this gloss black on the things I want to chrome, and then put the chrome over the gloss black, and hopefully that'll give the chrome little bit of extra pop, but we'll see. I also have an assortment of Testor's enamel model paints for detailing some of the smaller pieces, and I'm just going to be shooting those through my airbrush. And I also have a silver Sharpie, which I will be using to detail the tires. Using this instead of a small paintbrush is hopefully going to be a little bit easier. Some of the pieces might be a little rough. They might have some flashing left on them, so you might want to have some sandpaper. I'm using some 600 grit wet dry sandpaper, and I will also be using this between the coats of the black gloss to kind of smooth out the paint and make it all nice and neat for when I lay down the chrome color. Of course, when you're working with paint, you'll also need your general selection of paint thinners and solvents to clean up, rags and what have you. Let's take a look at how this body is put together. It's fairly straightforward and simple. The side mirrors are just held in with the Phillips head screw. Just back that out, just one screw on each side, and you'll be able to take those off. The roll bar and the rear bumper are held on by these clips. Those are a little tough to get off. They take a little bit of work, but they are reusable if you're careful. So you'll just pull them off, and if you bend them up too much, you can re-bend them back into shape, and they should work just fine when you're ready to put this back together. And then the toolbox on the back here is also held in by two screws. So I'm going to go ahead and start disassembling this, and then we'll go on to the next step. Gone ahead and removed the side mirrors, the toolbox, and the spare tire. Right now I'm just going to show you real quick how I go about pulling these clips off. And you just want to be real gentle, kind of work your way around them, tug them a little bit, lift them up. You don't want to try and force them all in one shot. Just work them around, and eventually you'll get to the point where they'll just pop off. Now I've kind of bent that one up a little bit, so I'm just going to move up in my needle nose pliers to the flat spot and just give them a bit of a press, and that'll flatten them out well enough that you can reuse them. Alright, all the pieces are removed. Got your rear bumper, the roll cage. You can take this apart further if you want. It's just a few screws, and there's no real need to, but just if you want to. These are a couple braces from the bottom side of the body. I'm not going to worry about painting these since they'll be hidden, but at this point I'm going to take all these pieces, run them under some soapy water, get them all cleaned up, and I'm also going to take some time to kind of sand these with some very fine grit sandpaper, because if you've seen any of our videos with this truck, you know it's taking quite a beating, and there's a little bit of road rash here and there. So I'm going to clean that up with some sandpaper, wash them up real good, and then I'll start painting. Pieces have been washed and sanded relatively smooth as I could get them. I'm going to do one more step before I start painting, and that's go through and remove all the decals off these things. The new clear body, if you're going to be going that route, has new decals for all these if you want to use them. I might find something else to use in place of them, but we'll see. So to remove the decals, they should just be pretty easy to pull off, but if you need to use your hobby knife, I'll make it go a little quicker. And then once you get all these pulled off, the way I'm gonna work on painting this, since I don't know how that silver paint is gonna react, I'm gonna put primer on all these pieces first. And then for the parts that I'm going to be doing the chrome silver, I'm going to do that a coat or two of that gloss black, and then I'll do a coat of the chrome. So those stickers are removed, and I'm going to grab my paints. You want to, of course, always take every precaution when you're using these aerosol paints or any paint. You don't want to be huffing in a lot of fumes. I'm sure some of you might want to do that, but it's not a good idea. So always use them in a well-ventilated area. I'm going to go ahead and take my stuff outside and give them all a couple quick coats, and then come back and check in with you. Got my parts all primered and a couple coats of black on the pieces that are going to be that silver chrome. Toolbox is still in primer color. Now what I'm going to do next is to get a nice smooth and even finish on these. When I do the chrome, I'm going to take them inside, take my wet dry sandpaper, and just give them a bit of a light wet sanding. That should smooth out any bumps and bubbles and anything like that. So I'll go ahead and do that real quick, and then I'll start painting the chrome. While I'm waiting for the other parts to dry off before I start painting them, I'm going to go ahead and see what I can do with this, get the paint going on my little toolbox here. I originally planned on painting it red with a white top, kind of like a beverage cooler that I'm sure most of you are familiar with. But I forgot to buy a bottle of red when I was at my hobby shop yesterday. So instead I mixed a custom color out of a couple colors I had on hand. So a lot of orange, a little bit of brown, kind of a darker orange in there. I think it'll be just fine. Next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to mask off just the top part so I can have that white top with the dark orange cooler color. And with that, I'm going to use my painting masking tape, which I always keep sealed up in a Ziploc bag to keep it clean. So I'm going to go ahead and do that real quick, and then I'll start spraying. Okay, got that done. Pinch off the top, make sure don't get any overspray in there, and just go around it one more time with the fingernail, just to make sure you got it pressed down nice and tight where you want it. Okay, got my airbrush set up to my air compressor. I'm going to start out shooting about 25 psi, see where that gets me. I've thinned my paint out about 1-to-1 mix with some thinner. I'm just going to use a couple light thin coats. You don't want to go too heavy right away. Just enough to start getting some color on there. And then you're going to set aside, let that first coat dry for a little while, and then I'll come back and finish it. Went ahead and finished the toolbox. Didn't turn out too bad. I kind of like it. It still needs to dry a little bit. Let it set overnight. When I pulled the tape off, I pulled up a little bit of the white paint around the edge. So I just took my little paintbrush and did a couple touch-ups around there. But this is done. I also did a last coat of the silver chrome on the roll cage and rear bumper and whatnot. And those should be dry here within the next couple hours. Last coat of my chrome paint on my body pieces is dry to the touch now, but it's not fully cured yet. The stuff is still pretty soft, so you don't want to be handling it right away. I'm going to let it sit overnight, but one thing I have learned about this kind of chrome paint that I used is that it goes on real heavy. It's a real thick paint. You can't spray on in light coats at all. It seems to work just great on this plastic with the primer and the black base coat. It doesn't have a full-on chrome look. It's got a little bit of a reflection to it, but it has more of a satin finish than a chrome finish. I am kind of wondering about the durability of it. We'll see how that goes. One thing you could probably try to make it a little more durable is to clear coat the pieces, and I may end up doing that depending on how well it lasts. But so that part is done. I'm going to show you one more detail you could do to the wheels and tires. This is actually outlined in the manual for the Evader DT. DuraTrax is kind enough to tell you how to do it, but you want to kind of make these raised letters on the tires stand out a little more. What you can do is you take your silver Sharpie, and then the easiest way I found to do it is to go from the side. You want to, of course, clean it all up first. Make sure there's no dirt or anything that could get in the way. Maybe rub it down with some rubbing alcohol, just in case there's any oil or grease stuck on it. But take your Sharpie sideways instead of trying to write on it like this, like you'd normally write on a piece of paper. Go in and just brush it on sideways, and you should be able to have a little bit more control over what you're doing. That way you're not bumping off to the side trying to keep your hand steady going this way. If you just brush it like this, it works out just great, and those on that lettering will really start to stand out. Just add another little touch of detail to this truck. So I'll go ahead and I'll finish doing that real quick around the rest of the wheels. And then another thing you can do is these wheels are faux beadlock style. They're not real beadlocks, obviously, but they do have bolt heads molded into them. And you can take your Sharpie, color those in so you have silver bolt heads against the black beadlock ring, and that'll give a little bit more pop. So let me go ahead and finish that, and I'll show you what the final result looks like. Got the detailing on the tire all done. Made the raised lettering silver. Kind of looks kind of white in the light. Doesn't matter. Got the bolt heads colored in. It's just a great way to add a little touch of detail to an already awesome looking truck. All of this can be done in, well, painting time. Take a few hours. You gotta wait for it to dry and cure properly. But, in a day and a half, you can have a completely different looking truck. Tomorrow I'm going to start painting the new clear body. It's got all new decals with it that I may or may not use some of them. I haven't quite decided on the scheme I'm going to go for yet. I think I might go with the gray with a little bit of silver flake in it, a little bit of red, a little bit of black on it. But that'll be tomorrow's show. With that, I'm Jeff Hoy with Big Squid RC. Thanks for watching, and come back tomorrow.